him. Lovely! Don't forget anything you need to know about matches on Teletext, page 650. Don't forget, of course, Mugshot is the game that everybody wants to play, and in case you don't know how to play it, I will now demonstrate it for you. We have a screen. The screen is divided into 9 squares. We reveal bits of the flesh in squares to reveal the face of a famous, oh yes, a very famous celebrity. And possibly a rather gorgeous one with lovely lips there. She's got lovely hair. It is, of course, Cathy Dennis, who is also our special guest on MASH today, Cathy!
Woohoo!
Thank you. Thank you. Fine, I've just had one of your monkey nuts. It was delicious.
You're welcome. Peel away. You can pick on me monkey nuts all you like.
Thank you.
I do believe that you know the number that people need to phone to play Mugshot.
I do indeed. It is 0891100101.
Wonderful stuff, like a professional there. You've also brought along some of your favourite things, I believe. What are your favourite things in life, Cathy Dennis?
Well, 5 of my favourite things are fast cars.
Fast cars?
That's
a fast tractor, actually, isn't it?
Yeah, I'm a bit disappointed. I don't think I'm going to get much speed out of that one.
No, I don't think
never mind.
Are you a bit of a speed queen?
Yeah, I do. I like to put my foot down.
Ooh, but I hope you're careful, darling.
Oh, I'm... Believe me,
and you always put
careful.
Your belt on, don't you?
Of course I do.
Of course you do, lovely. Next up.
Don't want to do anything illegal.
Of course not.
Mobile phone. This is a really lovely one. I'd love to
It's sort of dog and bone, that, isn't
it? I'd love to take this one home, actually, yeah. I love the fact that with a mobile phone, you can always be in contact with your mates. And,
yes.
You know.
Who do you phone most often?
Probably my girlfriends, yeah.
Oh. Do you have little girly chats, discuss nail varnish, stuff like that?
We do, actually,
do you?
Yeah.
It's amazing, isn't it? That's a nice, but where do you speak into on that phone? That worries me a bit.
Yeah.
Yes, all right, we'll
I don't
move
think
swiftly
it's
along.
There, no.
Where's next? What's next on the
next list? Next is one of my favourite foods in life is Farley's Rusks.
Farley's Rusks? It's baby food, isn't it?
It is, but they're delicious, and I love to eat them instead of having like a normal biscuit. You know, you can eat these, and they're full of vitamins and minerals.
Are they?
Yes. Would you like to try one?
I wouldn't mind, actually. Thank you very much. Maybe they need to add a bit of milk to them later. Thank you very much. Sorry, Farley. What's next, Kath?
Next is... Yes. You can call me Kath. It's okay.
Kath, is that all right? You know, don't want to be too casual. You know,
I have 2 Labradors at home who are called Charlie and Joseph.
Oh.
And they are my 4th favourite thing.
So we've got little cuddly toys here to remind you.
Yes, we have.
Of the little sweethearts.
One of them looks a
nothing
little bit
like that. Yes.
And then the other one, actually, I'm afraid to disappoint you, looks a bit more like that.
Can you point the other end of the camera? Fair enough. Now, what about your last one?
I love them just the same.
What's your last favourite thing then that you brought along today?
My last favourite thing. Well, I haven't actually brought it along.
No.
But I'm going to, well, God.
Go on.
One of my favourite things in life is I spend a lot of time impersonating dancers.
Impersonating dancers?
And there was this thing called the Brian Rogers dancers.
Oh, yes.
And they used to do all these summer specials and, you know, kind of holiday programs.
Yes. Oh, can you give us a demo? Come on, Cathy.
Well,
careful, don't do a baby spice on us now, will you, and go upside down.
They do all these really happy things with their faces and they just, look, everything is fantastic. And
oh, yes. Oh.
Yeah.
I can do that, me.
Brian Rogers dancers.
Can I be the Brian Rogers dancers?
Watch your hands, because you lucky people. There you go, Cathy, there's one for you.
Oh,
oh thank you.
There,
you
got to test that out for us. Jarvis, I'll be forcing this down your throat a bit later on. So thank you very much for those top 5, Cathy. That was great. We're still waiting to hear from your top 5s, actually.
Yes,
so
indeed.
Any top 5 list you want whatsoever, and send it into the usual address. That's MASH at Tynties Television, P.O. Box 1TN, Newcastle upon Tyne, NE99 1TN. Get them writing in.
Yes, indeed. A break's coming up soon, but also we want your questions. Careful, Jess. To Cathy Dennis. Cathy, do you know the number that people need to call to ask questions to you?
I do indeed. It is 0990100300.
Yes, indeed. And the people that phoned in and we read their questions out, they also win a lovely prize from the mashed pile of goodies. But now, there they are, you see. What a range of prizes.
Mm.
Little break coming up now. After the break, Daffy Duck's going to be here, isn't he?
Yes.
First time ever that Daffy will be in the house. Daffy's in the house.
Fun
and
rough.
Also, yes. No, not another one. We'll have plenty today.
Okay, Duck.
Who'll do almost anything for a book?
Hey.
Yay! Fantastic stuff again. There. More cartoon fun later on with the Animaniacs. Now we've got to pay some competitions off now. And we've called in the Glamour Task Force to help us. Yes, it is.
There you are. Yes, competitions thick and fast last week. The first competition, the winners are going to win the boys' video. That's down there. Now, the question for that was, what are boys in the nursery rhyme? Now, depending on what part of the country you were in, yes, it was either slugs, frogs, or snips, whatever they are, then snails and puppy dog tails. A bit difficult, but there's five winners in there, Cathy. So
okay,
if you'd like to pull them out and
have a delve, pick away.
Just five at a time or one at a time? Emily Lamb. Oh, Emily Lamb.
Yeah. Emily Lamb.
From Middlesex. You've got
yes,
one?
She's a winner. Emily, lovely. Who's next?
My name is Jodie Thomas. I come from Swansea, Wales.
Jodie's
no
a winner too.
On here.
Oh, but...
I'm sorry.
Well, and now Jodie will get in contact.
Put your addresses on, please.
Karen Walls, Fife.
Yeah, she's from Fife.
Yes.
And there you go, I've got one.
Claire Hesse, North Yorkshire.
Claire, well done.
There you go, the last one.
Gemma from South Wirral.
So well done to you, Gemma Wilde.
Nice
it was.
One, Gemma. Yes, also we've got some lovely Tap Dogs prizes to give away. And they go to people that knew that the children's ITV drama, in which a little boy turns into a dog, is, of course, woof, woof, woof. Cathy, have a look. Pick
what,
out
two winners.
This box.
That's that one.
Two winners, please.
I think. I'll pick out two. Oh, my God. Yes. Martin Corbett of Blackpool.
He's at 16.
Kim Southwell of Hull.
And she's 10, so well done to you, Kim.
Well
now,
done.
On the third section...
Oh, yes.
Sorry, is this me?
It's you. No,
oh, thank you very much. On the third section, it's your chance to win an inflatable basketball set, so this could be coming to your garden soon.
It looks like the States, doesn't it? It's Val Kilmer.
Woo-hoo! Right, OK. There was one winner in that, and they got the answer to which movie did the two play basketball? Of course, it was Space Jam. So one out of the middle section, please, Cathy.
It is Jason Burchett of Wolverhampton.
And he got it right, so that's on its way to you, Jason. Well done, son.
So I think I'm having a mystic mega attack here. Just went, oh, yes, the winners of the gold, the guitars for Galp House video, which you can see to my right if the camera moves over. But no, it isn't. It were people that knew that Mark Aaron did a trial for Manchester United, and they are Rachel Taylor from London, Jane Allen from Birmingham, and John Campbell from Cumnock in Air, Sarah Temple from Washington, not USA, but Tyne and Weir, and Laura Cottrell from Longford in Kent. She'll be celebrating too.
Jarvis, stop it now, you're scaring me.
Oh, I don't know
you're
what happened.
Scaring me. Sorry about looking that. Anyway, mate, anyway. So finally, congratulations to Joanne Devlin, who's 14 from Dumbarton. They're up on your screen now, and Callum Mellon. He's age 7 from Otley, and as we speak, they are currently enjoying a lovely weekend at Sir Bobby Charlton's soccer school.
Oh,
courtesy of us!
Yes, aren't we generous? Phew! Cathy, what's coming up next?
Say Animaniacs.
Animaniacs!
It must be the Animaniacs!
It's time for Animaniacs!
They're just going to be self-organised. I love the Animaniacs, I just get engrossed with it and forget to rehearse what I'm doing. Yes, more tune fun later on with the Batcave, but I think now we should pick a picture to put on our mashed House of Tunes board.
Definitely.
Here's one that I really like. This is coming from Tanya Carter from Hutton, Brentwood in Essex, and she's 14, and that is a lovely picture of the Animaniacs you've just seen.
Mm. Now there's one from Nadege Stoddard. She's from Jersey. She's 5 and a half. Thank you very much for that.
Sweet.
Will that be a winner?
Lovely. Cathy, have you got one?
Yes, I have. Look at this one. Fantastic.
Wow.
From Amy Dennis, who is not a relation of mine, age 7, of Glasgow.
Oh, brilliant picture.
Very nice. Yes. Here's a nice one, too. This is, well, there's everybody in here, I think. This has been sent in by Sarah Ellison from Preston in Lancashire. She's 13. Thanks for that, Sarah. Love, life.
And lastly, but not leastly, there's Bugs in his little circle. That's Rebecca Southall, or Sokol. She's 10 of Devon, so I hope I got that right. Now,
Cathy, we need you to pick one.
Pick a winner.
This is your fave, do you think, to go on the board? It's a hard decision.
Oh, God, they're really good, all of them are. But I think this one, because I like big.
Yeah, and probably you. All his felt tips up. There we go.
Just dig it on the board, mate.
Right, I'm going over to the board. There you go. Cathy has chosen yours. Amy Dennis.
And it's not my relation.
Over Glasgow. And it's not, definitely not a relation. So there
see you later, Amy.
There you go.
Keep all your tune pictures coming in. Cathy, what is the address for people to send their pickies to?
The address is Mashed P.O. Box 1TN, Newcastle-upon-Tyne, NE99 1TN.
Please keep those pickies coming in. We're going to have a little break now, but don't go away, because there's still all of this to come on today's Mashed. Yes. Yes.
And welcome back. We're joined by the lovely Cathy Dennis on the sofa. This is the spotlight time for you, Cathy, because they've been phoning in and want to ask you some questions. All right, you can look for that.
You look very comfy there, Cathy.
I am, they're really nice.
That's nice.
Comfy cushions. I've got some trainers like that as well.
Have you?
It's lucky I didn't wear them, isn't it?
It is. We'd have looked like sisters.
The first question for you comes from Stuart McPhail, who's 12 from Bude. Do you like listening to your own singing?
Oh, actually, I don't spend a lot of time listening to anything I've done before. I tend to always look ahead. And if it's something that's current, then I might listen to it. I don't really listen to anything I've done in the past.
Uh-huh. But you sing in the shower?
I usually sing other people's songs. Uh-huh. I'm singing a lot of Frank Sinatra at the moment.
Oh, yeah.
When you hear stuff that you did like a few years ago, you tend to think, well, I wish I'd done it a bit more like this. Are you very critical?
I am very critical, but yeah. I tend to accept what I've done, and I think, well, that was that, and it can't really be changed.
It can't?
No.
It can't, you're
have
right
there.
Have
you got a viewer's question there, Jarvis?
I have indeed. Amy Innes, who's 13, she's phoned from Stockton.T. She says, what's the strangest gift a fan has ever given you? Because you were helping yourself.
You've got quite a few earlier. You've been over in America quite a lot, haven't you?
And I have, but I think probably one of the strangest gifts... I have been given a banana.
You never have.
I have. But
that's the wages I get on this show.
I think the strangest gift is a watering can that somebody gave me.
Oh, why a watering can?
Very domestic something.
Well, somebody heard that I liked talking to my yucca plants. And they...
Right.
And that's really sweet, isn't it? So I've got this lovely green watering can.
Stop it, you.
Watch it, yeah, she's bonkers.
It wasn't, it was a fan.
She's talking to the yucca now, that's bad enough.
All right, okay. Now, Crystal from 14 of New Haven, what was she doing before you became famous?
What were you doing?
Well, I've had a couple of normal-ish jobs. I worked in an insurance company for... Uh-huh. A short while, and I've worked in.
Was
I
that
know.
A bit dull compared?
Ooh, no,
the
job.
Only great thing about it was the cream cakes when it was people's birthday.
Oh,
right, lovely.
Other than that, I spent even shorter while working in a shoe shop, and then
People's feet really smell because I mean it's got to go down.
Yes.
And light up, yeah.
I find that the worst feet are actually.
Oh yeah, I've found that as well. What? So a lot of chimpanzees came in your shoe shop.
They did.
Yeah,
they did.
Fair enough.
They smell all right to me.
Yeah, well. Well, you got a blocked nose.
Fair enough.
Another viewer's question.
Yes, Michael Caine, not the Michael Caine,
Michael
I presume,
Caine,
who's
Michael
11,
Caine.
From CM says, what's your favourite Looney Tunes character? That's a question out of the blue, isn't it?
Yes, I think Bugs Bunny.
Oh.
Because it's the ears. I just love interesting ears.
Oh, stop it. He'll go again. Hold on, it gets
don't
all...
stop, you killjoy.
Well, I don't get anything. You get kissed by Esther from Eternal. Cathy plays with your ears and I'm sat here like a lemon. Well, I'm not bitter. I'm all right about it.
Bitter lemon.
We're going to be watching your video in just one second. What kind of music would you say it is? How would you describe it?
Well, it's one of the slower songs from the album. It's there's quite a lot going on the new album, but this is slightly more romantic, as I am.
Romantic. We like romantic.
Well, just introduce the video.
All right, sorry.
It's called When Dreams Turn to Dust, and the single, and it's all about a dream I had.
Oh,
there it is.
Oh, how romantic.
I don't want to alienate you.
dreamy video. That's lovely, that is. Stop the rocking before I'm sick.
Hey, top man.
We'll see you later. Thanks a lot, Jez.
Cheers, Matthew, top man.
What's all this first name term business?
Yeah, well, you know, friends of the stars. We only saw three acts there, but obviously you can see all 12 tonight.
I'll definitely watch them. Has anybody ever impersonated you on Stars in Their Eyes?
They have, actually, yeah.
Were they any good?
I didn't actually see it myself. My sister did, and they got the outfit really, really good. It was a red...
I'd be scared in case they were better than the original. Had it
be? Well, that wouldn't be difficult in your case, would it?
Oh, hey!
Coming back right at you.
Yes, indeed. Next week on the show, the Stars of Hollyhouse.
Yeah, we've got Kurt and Ruth, who have just gone through a murder trial.
Yes,
so.
Indeed. That'd be more entertaining than Kurt and Paul.
Who's they? I don't get it. I just laughed because I thought it might be funny. And also, well, we'll be here anyway.
Please see some more of Cathy's video.
Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
It's been a pleasure.
See ya.
Say goodbye.
Ta-ra.
Bye.
Bye.